There's two sides to this. There's the political influence of the Turkish government, which has, over the course of a century, managed to stifle and repress and deny this event. And today, their strategic importance is greater than ever. And this is a touchstone for them. Any time that the Armenian Genocide is mentioned, whether it be the centenary or a film like this, there's immediately a barrage of denial. And the thing is, it's for me and for the world to face this, it's not, this is not a question of did it happen or if it happened. The vast majority of historical study in this has firmly established that this was a planned attempt to wipe out the Armenian nation. And we need to get beyond that diversionary discussion to why. Why did it happen, and how do we move on from that, and how do you reconcile these two nations again? And for me making this, I think one of the most important things, and this has also been denied, but a British barrister, Geoffrey Robinson, very distinguished, has firmly established this. Adolf Hitler in 1939 held a meeting of his generals in one of his villas before they invaded Poland, and he was talking about creating breathing, living space for the German people. And he instructed those generals that they had to be completely brutal and wipe out populations and villages and so forth. And he had an argument, particularly with one Admiral Canaris, who went on to be one of the attempted assassins of him. And Canaris wrote in his diary afterwards, Hitler turned around and said, "Who now speaks of the Armenians?" So the very suppression of that event and the fact that it hadn't been recognized became justification for more slaughter. So this whole event needs to be brought out into the open. It needs to have the light of discussion put onto it, and it needs to have a sense of reconciliation. And the more you keep denying that, the deeper into the hole of not getting to that position. So that's the overall task for us. Let's bring the discussion out into the open here and have it.